We all are different. We vary in size, weight, body form, or foot proportions. We become even more different because of things which happen in our lives. Events like traumas and joint diseases can have a significant effect on our musculoskeletal system. In modern medicine, most of these effects are cured with quality-crafted implants used to restore teeth, limb joints, and even spinal intervertebral discs. Although standard implants are widely used in many situations, the main question still bears asking. If our anatomies are so unique, are standard solutions really the best for us?
The main advantage of custom-made implants when compared to standard implants is the patient-specific design, which will match the implant to the bone and not vice versa. Using a custom-made implant provides a complete biomechanical harmonization of the replaced joint, not only locally, but with respect to the neighboring joints as well. Those specific advantages ensure lower surgical invasiveness, shorter surgery duration, faster healing times, reduction of risk of infection, joint dislocation, and revision surgeries. This process provides a more complete restoration of the patient's physical performance. This results in a high quality of life by reducing or completely eliminating side effects. 3D printed patient-specific implants have been used in clinical practice for only 10 years. Not enough clinical data has been accumulated on the efficiency of the use. However, the aforementioned advantages provide the assumption of a longer lifespan for the patient.
Despite all the advantages, patient-specific implants currently fail to achieve large-scale commercial success over much inferior standard implants. This is mainly due to high price, long lead times, surgical approaches which are oriented towards standard solutions, as well as existing long-standing relations between surgeons and manufacturers of standard implants.
Although patient-specific implants are more expensive, it's important to remember that the implant price is just one component of the treatment costs. I strongly believe that the potential application of patient-specific implants should be expanded beyond oncological and other rare clinical cases. Patient-specific implants should also be used whenever it leads to better treatment results, ensures a more complete restoration of a patient's physical performance, and decreases the total accumulated treatment costs. I'm sure if the amount of implant costs is reduced as proportion of overall treatment expenditures, in the long run, patient-specific implants will prove more economical than the use of standard implants.
To support the development of a mass customization technology platform that significantly alters the way surgical practice and the entire implant industry operates, the European Commission, via Horizon 2020 SME Instrument Funding Program, has granted Lithuanian company Ortho Baltic over 1.5 million euros. This grant will allow Ortho Baltic to develop technological solutions that ensure effective management of implant design, manufacture, and validation processes. The company already offers patient-specific implants for a price that is lower than those from modular standard implants. The lead time is currently at 4 weeks, but with the transition to mass manufacturing and at least 3,000 patient-specific implants produced annually, their price is projected to be half as low as it is today, with lead times not exceeding 2 weeks.
Offering surgeons premium quality patient-specific implants for competitive price and short lead times does not provide surgeons enough incentives to more widely utilize patient-specific implants. We have to introduce IT tools which will empower surgeons to describe in a natural way the individual design to be implemented in an implant for the treatment of specific patient. This will eliminate continuing to twist and turn trying to solve the problem of how to make do with what we have by using standard implants.
The patient-specific design process starts with order initiation. The surgeon authenticates to the Surgeon Manufacturer Communication and Co-creation web platform MICE, Medical Implants Customization Engine, to initiate an order. He uploads patient-specific radiological images. He gets back from the implant manufacturer a reconstructed patient-specific anatomical 3D model, which describes the requirements for the custom-made implant design and assembly. The surgeon points out where the bone resection is planned, how to position the implant and attach it to the bone, how much and what surgical guides will be needed for resection of the bone, and to determine the angle and depth of the screws. Through the MICE web platform, the surgeon will provide the manufacturer with other required patient-specific information, such as the specification for antibiotics and their release terms. Infection prevention is one of the most important elements of implant personalization. The implant designer follows these surgeon's requirements to design a patient-specific implant, as well as a personalized anatomical model, which was constructed from radiological images. The implant design is then tested with the FEM methods and software to determine the strength characteristics of the designed implant. The designer will also assess whether the implant design, in conjunction with the patient's anatomical 3D model, meets the requirements of international harmonized standards like ISO and ASTM. Once the designed implant successfully passes FEM tests, the surgeon must verify that the designed implant, together with initial requirements, personalized surgical guides, mounting screws, and tools used during the surgery, matches the patient's virtual anatomical 3D model. This verification is performed within MICE web platform in virtual space by simulating pre-operative planning. If the surgeon is happy with the result, he confirms the manufacturer's solution, at the same time taking full responsibility for its suitability. The manufacturer will take further responsibility for the production stage of implant design and assembly. And at that point, an approved and prepared order is ready for production.
For factory floor management, we developed a lean torque-based processes optimization platform called MC Dynamics, designed to manage the mass production of single orders. It ensures machine-to-machine communication and processes automation adjusted to the specifics of digitally nature custom-made implants design, manufacturing, and validation processes. MC Dynamics is managing all product supply chain, starting from order placement using MICE software and continuing through manufacturing, quality control, packaging, sterilization, and delivery processes. In single manufacturer type of patient-specific implants production, quality assurance is only provided by humans. With mass customization business model, the same human quality assurance processes are further controlled by software systems.
Patient-specific implants and their individual components are made of medical titanium, cobalt chromium, various types of ceramics, and polyamides. Direct metal laser sintering and electron beam melting technologies, designed to use a high-power density laser and electron beam, respectively, to melt and fuse metallic powders together, are most commonly used here. Because implants are printed from titanium powder, high tensions are generated inside the metal during the melting phase. Thus, special supports are designed which prevent deformations during the 3D printing process. Patient-specific surgical guides are printed from biocompatible polyamide materials using selective laser sintering technology. This technology is more simple to use and doesn't require the design of supports. Laser selectively fuses powdered material by scanning cross-sections generated from a 3D digital description of the part from a CAD file on the surface of a powder bed. After each cross-section is scanned, the powder bed is lowered by one layer thickness, and a new layer of material is applied on top. The process is repeated until the part is completed. As implants are 3D printed, the finishing process is performed. First, to remove the internal metal tensions generated during 3D metal printing process. After that, the support structures are removed. Further, depending on the 3D printing technology used, there is a longer or shorter surface finishing process. It involves mechanical surface treatment using sandblasting, milling, vibrating hopper, ultrasonic cleaning, high-pressure water jet, and polishing. In order to increase the covering surface of the implant and bone contact and improve its osteointegration, the polished implants are additionally sanded, annotated, or coated with different hybrid coatings. Quality assurance for patient-specific implants is implemented at all stages of implant design and production. The very last and most important step is final quality control. The implant is scanned by an industrial computer tomograph. The integrity of the implant's internal structure and the compliance with the virtual CAD model that was agreed upon with the surgeon is validated. The roughness of the surface of the produced implant is further measured, and a spectroscopic analysis is performed to ensure that the product has not been contaminated with other materials during the manufacturing process. If everything is approved, the medical device and its accessories are further directed to the cleaning area, where washing, packaging, and sterilization are performed. The custom-made implant is ready for delivery to the operating room.
If there are still doubts today as to patient-specific implants being as safe for the patient as their standard counterparts, I can assure you they are significantly safer. Implant personalization transfers the center of weight from inoperative to preoperative preparation, thus anticipating potential risks and complications before the surgery. Moreover, not only the surgeon, but also the clinical engineer and implant designer participate in preoperative preparation process. Production, quality assurance, and final quality control processes are in the line with what is today called the fourth industrial revolution. While designing a custom-made implant, we see a real person in front of us. We see his disability and we are eager to help him. We are always concerned about the success of the surgery while using our implants. Therefore, we always look forward for feedback from the surgeon and especially from the patient.
The switch to personalized medicine is already taking place due to changing trends in healthcare itself and in healthcare compensation systems. The emphasis has shifted from number of treatments and is progressively moving to outcomes of the treatments. Personalized medicine not only improves the quality of life, but also contributes to more sustainable healthcare in EU countries. It drives new and faster development processes and products, which provides European life sciences industries with a competitive edge. Patient-specific implants are a pioneering element in this transformation.